Okay, here we go. We're doing water. Only colors we need are going to be green and red. Oxygen comes as O2. Hydrogen comes as H2. So this is a gas. This is a gas. You can freeze them. Become liquids. Space shuttle. We're going to use the space shuttle as an example. Liquid oxygen, LOX. Liquid hydrogen, LH2. We're going to do photosynthesis because CO2 in water makes the sugar that when it combusts goes back to CO2 in water. So we're going to start with water, H2O. You're going to have to balance this equation, which means you're going to need two of these because, see, one oxygen needs two H's, right? So for the other oxygen, you're going to need two more H's, H2's. So H2O looks just like Mickey Mouse or Mickey Mole. So we're going to draw this. 104.5 degrees is the angle. Really popular little constant to remember. We'll write that later. Two lone pairs of electrons down here. This is in 3D space, tetrahedral, just like the CH4, the methane. Well, the electron pairs are going to force these closer together instead of being a true tetrahedral. And this is where nobody in chemistry questions this. Look, all the protons are in the middle for oxygen, right? 8 protons, so you got 2 electrons in the inner shell. To get the octet, you got 6 by themselves, so these bring 7, that brings number 8. You have these 2 lone pairs down here, negatives. 2 pairs over here, 3D space, you know, fitting out there. Negatives. Negatives should repel each other, but they actually get this density in space because when they bump up next to another water, there's a proton off that. So that's what the beauty of water that makes it so unique. The simplest elements here have the most complex personality in the smallest amount of space. This is still the most heat liberating breaking of atoms that there is. So we're going to start with O2. It's going to split up to 2 O's. So here's 1 O. There's another O. What you need for the chemistry to know it all, there's 8 protons in the middle. So we're going to draw the 8 there. That's what's called the atomic number. Now the electrons, remember I said there's a pair in the inner shell. So we put 2 little ones inside the nose there. Inside the 8. See that? Now we need to get 8 all together. In the next shell, as they call it, okay? Well, along comes a hydrogen. And remember, hydrogen is usually always a proton. So here's our H2, okay? O2. So what you need to know about the chemistry is, for this bond in here, there's 2 electrons. One from the H, one from the O. Here's another 2. So you gotta be able to count the electrons. Slowing down so you can get it here. 1, 2, 3, 4 in the outer shell. 2 in the inner shell. That's 6. We need the octet, right? Here's number 7. 2, 4, there's 5, 6, 7, 8. See, these are lone pairs. There's no H on them yet. If I draw them as barbells, this is good because it's smaller. It's actually showing how it's smaller. So what do we have? 8 electrons. 8 valence electrons, 2 on the inside. We have 2 hydrogen atoms. So that's H with a dot. 2 of those. So 8 electrons in the outer shell for water. These 2 are for oxygen. They don't even get near the proton, so you don't even think of those inner ones. Valence of 8. The 8 are 2 bonding to one of the hydrogens, another 2 bonding to the second hydrogen. 2, 4. The I's here. 5, 6. Give them a lone pair of electron here. 7, 8. Remember the octet? That's why you stopped. The periodic table is all based on this octet of a valence electrons here. Water is the perfect example. The H's each bring a proton to, or proton and its own electron. So bringing 2 of them replaces the 8 that it has all together because 2 are in the inner shell. I got to go over it and over and over it. Be able to say it. If you can say it, you'll understand it. The whole deal is counting electrons. So that's one water molecule. But see, O2 comes with this double bond to it here, it's called. So each of those is going to need 2 hydrogens. So we need twice as much. Now what happens is, ever seen the space shuttle? Shows this big orange tank. It's got the rockets on the side, right? It's got 2 compartments. One is twice as big as the other. So I always like to trick people and say which is in which. Something like a Harry Potter thing. Which is in which? LH2 is called liquid hydrogen. LH2 LOX is what they call liquid oxygen. So which one? We need twice as much here. So this is called a balanced equation. O2 plus 2 H2s go on to make 2 water molecules. We need 2 here. So now when you're counting them, you go 2 times O, 2 oxygens, 2 times H2 is 4 H's, which are the protons. So as you'll see, 2 water molecules, 2 H2O's is 4 H's. The good trivia thing on this is, oxygen is heavier than the hydrogen. And you need twice as much hydrogen. So which goes in which? Do you put the bigger tank on top? What they do is they use gravity to let the oxygen flow down to combust with the H2. So they actually takes more energy to pump the oxygen up higher into the space shuttle there. So the LOX goes in the top, and it's got the smaller of the 2 tanks. So there's LOX, and then here's the LH2. Not a lowercase, it's regular. So if you can learn this one reaction, this covers just about every chemical principle that there is. Okay, space shuttle, the orange tank. Now the side rockets are the solid fuels, but this is a liquid, remember? I said if you cool it, you get a liquid. If you cool it even further, it freezes. I'll tell you, for you real chemists here, they even have a thing called metallic hydrogen. I still cannot conceive it. Nobody's been able to answer it. They go, you can't describe it or something, but they say the core of Jupiter has metallic hydrogen that it's pushed together so far. I start wondering if nuclear reactions with the quarks starts happening, and I don't know. So, we're going to draw the second water molecule here. What do we need? A pair of electrons. Electrons. PBS soon. Doesn't that look like the little Arthur, right? You see, you can give them glasses because this is a pair. They are connected. This is water. Are you ready for this now? This is our alien. Let's see the electron pair on the oxygen. So we've got to remember this alien thing up here, too. That's the two lone pairs of electrons.